responsible for driving fear and confusion into 600 million people each year. One continent, no shame, and a lot of tiki-tiki-dak-daks.
Their kind of pop music is completely different. It's because of the language. I mean, the Scandinavians, with all the glottal stops and everything, they find it impossible. The best single example of it was that when ABBA won the Eurovision, they were singing in English. The year before, they had failed to qualify, singing in Swedish.
Sweden was Eurovision. Once they were in Eurovision, they knew they had to sing in English because, to quote Bjorn, English is the language of rock and roll.
It's the right thing to do, and the Swedish and lots of other German bands have been able to sing in English very easily, and obviously it's been the key of their success.
Fred and Agneta had a busy year learning how to sing in English, whilst also scheming on how they would, through Eurovision, take over the whole world. Call it ABBA World and dress everyone in shiny things.
You have 3 minutes in Eurovision to really make an impact, something that could really, you know, smash across the television screen almost and really grab hold of people and say, you know, wake up, we have a good song here and you should listen to it. Waterloo, I was defeated,
you won the war. So they go out there and they sing in English about a battle between England and France, which was fought in Belgium. So they're covering many territories, and their victory was deserved.
Deserved indeed, but ABBA weren't going to have it all their own way. Back in their native country, throngs of hippies were arming themselves with lethal violins and playing unruly folk music to anyone who would listen.
Sweden, 1975. In the wake of ABBA's recent victory, a huge march through Stockholm protests about the lack of any national identity in Eurovision Song Contest entries. Protesters call for a return to traditional folk songs.
Go on, son, give it some stick!
Waterloo was obviously a massive hit for ABBA, and they want to follow up and they, you know, want to hold on to this success. But it seemed like they didn't really know how to do it, especially here in Great Britain, where they went with I Do, I Do, I Do, which was sort of naff. I can't conceal it.
Waterloo came out of a novelty program and therefore it had no credibility. So they had to let the cheesiness disappear before it could come with a campaign based on how good, you know, they actually were.
And then, of course, they were fortunate enough to come up with SOS. So when you hear me, darling, can't you hear me,
SOS? And the rest is ABBA history. 350 million sales worldwide. Only the Beatles have sold more records. And all because of Eurovision.
Being in that sort of competition is not going to do wonders for your credibility. So I think it was just that they worked very hard and just did their songs and really didn't listen to their detractors.
They probably are the only success story to really spring from the Eurovision Song Contest, apart from Bucks Fizz, who were just really cheap ABBA knockoffs.